Islam and France have been a topic of discussion for some time, especially in recent months. Now, in this episode, I'm going to explore some of the stats and history of Muslims in France, as well as some of the challenges that have come up along the way. Hey guys, what's happening? Welcome back to FTD Facts. My name is Leroy Kenton, and I was curious to know some facts about Muslims in France, and I wanted to share what I found with you. So this video is not going to dive too deep into the current situation, but it's going to be filled with a lot of statistics and facts just to sort of fill you in on where Muslims stand in France right now. All right, so let's take a look at number 10 to start off. Concrete data is really, really hard to come across because France considers ethnic and religious affiliation to be something that's very private. So not always the most accurate and up-to-date data is collected when it comes to this. But what we do know is that Muslims in France come from a large number of different countries. Although most of them do come from North Africa, mainly countries like Morocco, Tunisia, and Algeria, and that region is known as the Maghreb region, by the way. For number 9, did you know that France has the largest number of Muslims in the Western world? And this is mainly due to migration from the Maghreb region, like mentioned West Africa, and also migration from the Middle Eastern countries. According to the Pew Research Center, Muslims make up 8.8% of the total population of France, and that's roughly around 6 million people. Now, to go back some decades, according to the BBC, the first Muslims came to France many centuries ago, but the largest number of Muslims came to France in the contemporary era, and this was in the aftermath of the colonial wars of independence between the years 1954 to 1962. From there, the Muslim population in France really started to take off. Now let's take a look at where Muslims in France actually are. Well, the predominant Muslim population in France is in Paris, as well as Marseille, and also in Lyon and their surrounding suburban areas. But of course, if you go look in different parts of France, you'll find Muslim communities there as well. For fact number 6, when it comes to the Muslim share of Europe's total population, well, it's actually been increasing steadily and will continue to grow in the coming decades, it's estimated. From around the mid-2010s to 2016 alone, the Muslim share in Europe rose more than 1%. And that rose from 3.8% to 4.9%, and that works out to be 19.5 million to 25.8 million people. Of the Muslims, though, who currently live in the European Union, France is home to the largest number of Muslims, and that's equal to a third of the total Muslim population. We do have 5 more facts to look at in this episode, but before I get into those, just gotta mention, though, that we do have a similar video to this where we take a look at more of what's happening in France right now when it comes to Muslims and the French government. We dive a lot into the French law as well as Islamic law in that video. So definitely I'll want you to check it out because we cover a lot of information that we're not even gonna touch on in this episode. The link to that video is below in the video description. I'll also have it in the card section of this episode. Next up for fact number 5. France in 2004 actually banned headscarves in public schools, and this was all on the grounds that state institutions are supposed to be completely religiously neutral. This ban didn't just stop at Muslims, but it also extended to Christian crosses, as well as other Jewish attire. Back in the year 2010, France banned face covering, niqabs, and burqas in public, and they said that this was a move to promote open, equal interaction in all of French society. This ban, though, did set off some protests where people were going head-to-head with police. France was the first European nation to pass a nationwide ban like this. The next thing I want to share is that foreigners are also included in the ban. The law prohibits the wearing of face coverings in public places, and also it applies to foreign tourists visiting France. If you're caught violating, well, this law imposes a fine of up to 150 euros and or participation in citizenship education. The law also comes with a fine of 30,000 euros and 1 year in prison for anyone who forces, whether by violence or threat, to another person to wear face coverings, and these punishments may be doubled if the victim is under 18 years of age. There has been some response to this ban, though, specifically from Dalil Boubacar, who we're going to mention. He was the Grand Mufti of the Paris Mosque, which is the largest and most influential mosque in France. He testified to Parliament during the bill's preparation period, and he shared that the niqab was actually not something that was prescribed in Islam, and that the context that the French government was putting on the niqab was about radicalization as well as criminal behavior and associating that with Muslims. He also pointing out that this was actually completely inconsistent with France's concept of being a secular state. And he mentioned that rather than just doing a blanket ban, why not do the bans based on case, like case by case, because in different contexts, it can mean different things for people, as well as for certain security reasons. The next point to look at, it takes us to 2018 on October 23rd. That's when the United Nations Human Rights Committee, they published a statement that really came heavily down on France for human rights violations. This committee was responding to two complaints of women being prosecuted for wearing clothing that violated the French ban on face coverings. And this was a massive case for the UN Human Rights Committee because it was the first case by the committee to address the Islamic veil situation. The committee concluded that France had not provided enough reason for their ban on face veiling. What happened is that France was arguing that it was a necessary law in order for their community to better coexist and live in harmony. But the UN committee, they completely disagreed with this reasoning. However, not much has been done about it to this day. And the final fact I want to share in this episode, well, it doesn't seem like the Muslim growth in France specifically will be slowing down. I mentioned that Muslim growth in Europe is growing, but also according to the Pew Research Center, France received more than 500,000 Muslim migrants between the years 2010 and mid-2016. There are 400,000 Muslims that arrived also in Italy. And these two countries, by the way, accepted a combined total of 210,000 refugees. 80,000 of those were accepted by France. Most of them were Muslims. The Pew Research Center also predicts that the Muslim population, specifically in France, would rise to 8.6 million, which is a 12.7% increase by the year 2050. All right, guys, so that's all the time I have for you in this episode. This was a look at Muslims in France, 10 surprising facts. Be sure to join in on the conversation. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below. And also don't forget to check out the recommended video that I mentioned. That link is below in the video description section as well. Until next time, guys, stay awesome, stay educated, and I'll see you in another video.